Welcome to online digital marketing training. In this video, I'm going to explain about performance planner. You might have seen in main Google search network exam also, more than 10 questions they're asking about performance planner. Performance planner is a new tool Google have added recently, around 6 to 7 months back, but very few people are utilizing this. So I'll be showing what is performance planner is. I wrote a blog on this in ODMT. So as of now, you're running a campaign. So this is my campaign. So this is the main campaign here. You can see that we spent around $21,000 and we got $1,26,000 revenue. We got it. Okay. Now I want to know for the next 6 months, what is my performance? If I change my max CPC, my bidding, my daily budget, will I get the same profit or more profit? So this forecast I want to have. Then what we do as a marketers, we change the bidding. So as of now, our daily budget is something around $150. Then for the further improvements, we make it $200, $250. At the same time, we increase the max CPC. Then we will check how it is performing. But instead of you struggling it, Google made one option. So that is called a performance planner. So because the help of performance planner, create a plan to see forecast for your campaigns. So explore your forecast by adjusting different campaign setting, quickly implement changes prescribed to your plan. So you will see what are the options happen. Okay, if you increase your daily budget by 20% time, there is a possibility 40% more conversions happen. This is the idea plan Google gives. If you want it, you can apply it. So like see. So this is a new option Google added recently. And performance planner help you answer questions like, these are the questions. How my campaign perform if I spend more in next quarter? What can I do to take advantage of upcoming seasonal period? And how can I maximize conversion by maintaining my target CPA and target ROAS? Okay, right. So in order to go this, click on tools and settings. There is an option called performance planner. Click on this. Now you'll be having an option. Click on the plus. So once again, I'm explaining already you have existing campaigns, but for the future quarter, you want to experiment it by changing the bids and daily budget, you can use this option. And one more thing is, there is some eligibility. As of now, there is no eligibility for my campaigns. When you click on plus symbol, no forecast campaigns are available. And here, as of now, there are no campaigns which will be ready for the forecast campaign. So which campaigns are eligible? I mentioned that also. See, eligibility campaigns. Have you been running for at least 72 hours? Yes, I'm doing that anyway. Have received at least 3 clicks in the last 7 days? I've done. Have received at least 1 conversion in the last 7 days? Yes. The only thing is, as of now, I'm using the max CPC bidding, automatic bidding, max CPC. Yesterday, I told someone of you to come up with a bid strategies, right? In the bid strategies, conversion, CPA, target ROAS bidding methods also there. So if your campaign is using enhanced CPC or target CPA or maximize conversion bidding strategy, whenever you use this, then only this performance planner will work. Otherwise, it will not work. Maybe in the future, I'll be making the bid change, bid strategy as compared to them. Then I will see how it is working. As of now, for my campaign, max CPC is giving good benefit. That's why I haven't used it. Ineligible campaigns, deleted campaigns, you can't see the forecast, using shared budget, are not using manual cost per click and all these things. This is what I'm doing. Have been changed to meet the eligibility requirements, blah, blah, blah. So whenever you're trying to do it, you get a message like this, don't become panic. Maybe your campaign is not eligible. So come up here, see the requirement, run it, you'll understand. So you meet the requirement, then what happens? You meet the requirement. So So click on that, click on the plus symbol, then you will get options like this. What are the campaigns which are ready to forecast? It will be writing like this. Set the campaign for which you wanted a forecast. Then select the forecast period. Now when you click on the drop down, you'll be getting for the next month, next quarter, next 6 months, that option will be coming. Which metric you want to select, whether you want to check clicks or conversions, there is a drop down option will be there. And you can mention the number also here. After that, create a plan. So already existing campaigns are there. For the next 3 months, if I put a plan, what Google will do is, I'm showing you what Google will consider. Google, with the help of machine learning and competitors' data, how they're forecasting it, based on that, Google will give you results like this. So initially, your is here. Around 7.5 coming, your conversions actually. But if you increase it, there is a possibility you'll be getting. Get an estimated of 9.68 conversion value. Each conversion value is 3.9. When you spend 2,900. So this is the thing they're giving anyway. So whenever you increase the budget with this value, this many conversions are possible. Okay. And at the same time, they will give you detailed analytics like this. Existing as of now, how much you're getting? 1.36K. But if you go for this plan, $2.92K you'll be getting. The difference is this much. Conversion value as of now, 8.89. But plan, it's showing 9.6. So everything is benefit, then you can go for this. And you can compare them also. How you performing and how the forecast plan is also performing anyway. So changes will not take place until you implement them by downloading a file and uploading through Google AdWords editor. So after that, there is an option actually. Click on that. One file will be downloaded that you have to upload to a Google Ads editor. There is a separate tool you'll be learning in the future called Google AdWords editor. This is an offline tool. With this also, you can upload your campaign. So this is about performance planner. Already your campaigns are working, but you don't know how these campaigns works in the future if I change my bidding and daily budget. So come back here and see the forecast. Now let me show what kind of questions they're asking on the performance planner. A lot of questions they're asking. So why should your business use performance planner? What does performance planner automatically do? What can the performance planner recommended do that? So please search performance planner ODMT. All the questions I gave and the answers also I mentioned. So that in your Google Ads exam, you can easily answer your questions. If you have any questions regarding performance planner, put a comment so that I'll be replying back to you. Thank you very much.